There we go. Good morning. I think we're on. Excellent. How are you all doing this morning? Hope you're all feeling good, feeling well. So quick stretch out, because we're going to have our little body percussion warm up this morning. Warm up the shoulders, warm everything up. Good. So I'm going to teach you about ties this morning. Ties, like tying things in a knot. Anyway, we might get in a knot later, hopefully not. But a tie in music is when you simply tie two notes together. And you may think, well, why don't you just have one note, which is a very good point. So basically, you've got two sounds, yeah? Which is TT. But sometimes we need to tie those two notes together, and we have a, this is the symbol that it looks like. So if you see this, you may be used to this. Here's our two notes. You may be used to seeing that if you play any instruments known as a slur. And if you look at the pitch of these two notes, they are different pitches, aren't they? They go from lower to higher, just one step up. And a slur is when we tie two notes together and make them smooth. And we link them. So if you're playing like a trumpet or a flute or a clarinet, or you do it in a two, you wouldn't do a two, two. You wouldn't reset, make the sound. If you're doing it on a string instrument, you die. Do it in one bow as opposed to da da. We'd still have two sounds. So it's two sounds that are smooth. Now this is a tie. Looks exactly the same, right? A little slurry thing there and a little slurry thing there. The difference being the two notes are exactly the same. And this is, you think, why do you have to do that? It's because we've got a bar line in the middle. So we've just got two one beat notes and we have to add them both together with our tie and it becomes one two beat note. And we've had to write it like that because of this bar line. Okay, so we're going to just put that into how it feels. That's what it looks like, but we're going to put it into how it feels. So we're going to remind ourselves of our pa track. We're still going to keep things in our a one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three today. So we're going to start off with just listening to that threes and let's get some rhythms going. There we go. Here's some threes. Can you hear that three? One, two, three, one. Join in with me. Okay, so at the moment, one, two, three. We've got four different sounds, yeah? Now we're going to add in our tie. One, two, three, one, two. And we're going to put that last click, one, two, three, one, two, three. On the second beat, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one. Let's put it back to the first. One, two, three, one, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one. Should we do it different? Let's do one, two, three, one. Okay, now we're going to put that last click on beat two. One, two, let's put that last click on beat two now. down. Just felt we needed to finish off the song properly there. Well, that was a warm up, wasn't it? How did we find that? Okay, so hopefully we're all feeling our counts of three. Remember we did some conducting last week, which is our straight triangle, just to help us feel everything in this feel of three. So I'm going to teach you a particular rhythm that was just feeling different things. And our rhythm that we're going to do, we're going to think about our time. That's what we were doing there, by the way, when we were putting our clicks on the second beat, as opposed to them starting on the first beat. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That was the tie going from beat three to beat one. So here's a rhythm. In 3-4, that's what that means, of course. Three beat time, that's what tells us. So what we're going to do for this rhythm is we're going to do head. I'll show you. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so can we all have a go at that? Head, knees, clap, click, click. And ready, I'll put the track back on. Okay, are we ready? And a 1, 2, 3, off we go. Head, knees, clap, click, click. 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 Yeah, got that? In our tie, which just looks like that, yeah? Head, knees, click, click. 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 There we go. Okay, with the tie, and off we go. Head, knees, click, click. Notice, of course, number one rule is we always have to count beats. We always have to know where we are in our bars. And if you wonder what I'm talking about bars, bars is just a set of an amount of notes. It always has the same amount of beats in, and they are split up by a simple line, which is called a bar line, and it breaks music up. All music breaks it up into beats that we count in this repetitive 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. So what we're going to do to finish off with is put that rhythm we've just learnt into our waltz from last week, if you remember. And so we've now got three patterns. One of them is our new one. That's one of our patterns. The other pattern is a very straightforward, that kind of pa one, where we're clap shoulder, clap shoulder, clap shoulder, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So that's quite a straightforward three to start off with. Then if you remember, if you were doing it last week, then when the music got a little bit louder, got a little bit richer, more instruments joined in, we just kept that same rhythm, but put it in our foot, foot brush, brush, foot brush, brush. So the same feel, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, boom, pa, pa, boom, pa. awful as this oom-pow-pow is the feel of this waltz, because what's the most heaviest beat of the bar, the one that we always accent? I say always in this kind of music, beat one. So that's two of our rhythms. And the last one is when we've got, it just happens a few times in the middle. And we'll hear it, we'll pick it up. It's our tea, coffee, coffee, tea, coffee, coffee, tea, trick. There's a little time in there as well, if you can hear it. Tea, coffee, coffee, tea, coffee, coffee, tea, trick. And tea, coffee, coffee, tea, coffee, coffee, tea. Just join in with me. Let's get this rhythm. Tea, coffee, coffee, tea. Can we have a few times? Tea, coffee, coffee, tea, coffee, coffee, tea. With our 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and go. So there's our three rhythms that we do at different stages throughout this piece. We're going to put it all together and see if we can just follow each pattern. It changes, but just follow me and you'll be right. Okay, off we go. There's a really mega fast one, but I thought maybe we might all fall in a knot if we did that. So here's the we're going to feel our sense of three. Here's a little introduction to start with. Ready and off we go. Quite gentle waltz feel. Now let's put that in our feet. Off we go. One. Coffees. Again. One more time. And we do all of that again. Ready and off we go. If you manage to keep up with that or do some little improv waltz dancing I'm rather glad I didn't knock my dog over, who's just been sort of doing it down here. Thank you very much, everybody. See you next week. Have a really good day.